Then comes manufacturing overhead budget. As you all know that it include cost other than direct material and direct labor costs. So how we will make manufacturing overhead budget? We will use budgeted direct labor hours . We will multiply them with variable manufacturing overhead rate. We will get variable manufacturing overhead. We will add fixed manufacturing overhead. So we will get total manufacturing overhead. As you all know, the depreciation of factory equipments will be deducted. So are cash disbursement for manufacturing overhead will come. So it is the manufacturing overhead budget, in which we will not include direct material and direct labor costs. We will include variable manufacturing overhead that can be calculated by multiplying the direct labor hours with the variable manufacturing overhead rate. We will add the fixed manufacturing overhead, so we will get total manufacturing overhead, and the depreciation of factory equipment will be deducted from the total manufacturing overhead. The amount of cash disbursement for manufacturing overhead come. After it, we will do the process of ending finished goods inventory budget. Calculate the ending finished goods inventory budget. We will simply multiply ending finished goods inventory will be multiplied with unit product cost . So ending finished goods inventory will be calculated. So here is the question: how the unit product cost can be done or can be calculated? we can say unit product cost is equal to direct material plus direct labor plus manufacturing overhead. We will add these three costs, the sum we will get, and we will multiply that rate or that unit product cost with ending finished goods inventory to get the amount of ending finished goods inventory. To make it clear, we can write it in dollars. Then comes the concept of selling and administrative budget. Selling and administrative expenses budget. How it will be calculated, or how we made this type of budget? We will use budgeted sales unit we will multiply them with variable selling and admin expenses we will get the amount of variable selling and admin expenses. With it, we will add fixed selling and admin expenses. So the total selling and admin expenses amount will be calculated. Remember, we will also deduct the depreciation of admin and selling equipment, same like we did in manufacturing overhead. We deducted the depreciation of factory equipments. In the same way, we will deduct the depreciation of admin and selling equipment. So we will get the cash disbursement for selling and admin expenses. In this way, we will calculate, or we will build, selling and administrative expense budget. Then comes the concept of cash budget. For cash budget, if you remember the cash flow statement, it's very easy to make a cash budget. We will start with beginning balance of cash, add receipts of cash. What type of receipts can come of cash? Like sales receipts, receivables amount, and all the short-term assets that can be converted in easily into cash. When they will become the form of cash, we will add them. So after adding them, we will get cash, total cash available. We will less the disbursements. In easy words, the outflows. All the outflows or payments we did in the form of cash. After deducting, we will get the excess or deficiency of cash available over disbursement. After making all these type of budgets, that are the steps in the process of making master budget, we are able to make budgeted income statement, and budgeted balance sheet. It is the task assigned to you by me for our discussion session. You need to make budgeted income statement and budgeted balance sheet. This is your task to perform, and if I start review about the master budget, our master budget is the combination of dependent and independent budgets that normally lay out the company's sales, production and financial goals. Master budget accumulates cash budget, budgeted income statement and budgeted balance sheet. As you know, that cash budget I just made for you, and budgeted income statement and balance sheet you guys will make. If we start the process of making master budget, the first step was sales budget. The sales budget can be made, or we can easily prepare by multiplying the units sold with the selling price. This was the first step. Our second step was making production budget, because if the company is involved in the production process. So how the production budget is made? Budgeted unit sales will be, we will get the budgeted unit sales. We will add desired ending inventory. It means both inventory and unit sold or unit get sales will be added. We will get total needs, and after deducting the beginning inventory, required production will be calculated, that how much production of units is required. In the same way, if the company is not involved in production process, but company do sale and purchase, if it directly purchase the manufactured product, then it will be a merchandise inventory. What the company will do? Company will use budgeted sales, add ending inventory in the merchandise form. Total needs will come. It will deduct the beginning inventory. Required purchases will be calculated. So any one of step will come in the company. It will depend on the nature of company, whether it is a manufacturing company or whether it is a selling company. Then comes direct material budget. That is the part of production budget. For direct material, we will add raw material needed to meet production and add the ending inventory. Total raw material needs will come. We will deduct the beginning raw material. So the raw material to be purchased will be calculated. In the same way, as we are dealing with direct material budget, we will also make direct labor budget. For direct labor budget, the formula or the method is production units will be multiplied with the direct labor per unit and direct labor cost per hour. With it, we will get total direct labor cost. Then comes manufacturing overhead budget. As we have made the budget of direct material, direct labor, so manufacturing overhead budget will also there. It will include cost other than direct material and direct labor cost. direct material and direct labor cost. So how the manufacturing overhead budget can be made? We will use the budgeted direct labor hours. We will multiply them with the variable manufacturing overhead rate. The variable manufacturing overhead amount will come. We will add the fixed manufacturing overhead. The total manufacturing overhead will be calculated. Remember, as we are dealing with manufacturing overhead budget, we will deduct the depreciation of factory equipments from total manufacturing overhead. So cash disbursement for manufacturing overhead will come. Then comes the step of ending finished goods inventory budget. For that, we will multiply the ending finished goods inventory with the unit product cost. Unit product cost, how it will come? We will add direct material cost, direct labor cost, and manufacturing overhead cost. The sum of these three type of cost will give us the unit product cost. We will multiply with ending finished goods inventory. We will get the amount of ending finished goods inventory in dollars. Then comes selling and administrative expense budget. Again, we will use budgeted sales unit, multiply them with variable selling and admin expenses. We will get the amount of variable selling and administrative expenses. We will add the fixed selling and administrative expenses. The total selling and admin expenses will come. As remember, manufacturing overhead, we deduct the depreciation of factory equipment. In the same way, we will deduct the depreciation of admin and selling equipment from the total selling and admin expenses. So cash disbursement for selling and admin expenses will come. Then comes the concept of cash budget. For that, we will use the beginning balance of cash. We will add the receipts of cash. Total cash available will come. We will deduct the disbursements, cash outflows. So we will get the amount in excess or deficiency over disbursement. So budgeted income statement and budgeted balance sheet, that is also the part of master budget. You are already aware with the format of income statement and balance sheet. It will be your task.